I was here last year for the first time. I sang this song and I said I'd come back, and I did. There's a nursery rhyme, it's a favorite of mine, about a little girl and some sheep that she could not find. All her friends told her not to worry, they'd come back. Darling, you're my shepherd, I'm your little lamb. You ain't always gonna know where I am, but don't you this lovely little flower from. Ooh, ooh. Yeah, I like that. Don't you like those shows about gorillas? When they show the gorillas and what they do, they're very close to us, you know. From Mrs. Savannah King. Oh, Miss Savannah King. Well, Miss Savannah King, I thank you very much, darling. What's the matter with y'all over here? Y'all don't have no dang flowers for me? Oh! What? What? For the what? Oh, okay. We'll get to all that. We sort of like have planned a set. We don't just come out here and just say, well, let's sing this one now. Oh, now we got a sign. Ladies, I'll always come back. Do you hold me? Jane Brown. Well, all right, what else? I'll just stand on this. Is that okay? I mean, it is a doormat, all right? A lot been going on this past year, babies. I think I did this song last year. We just sort of put it on my new album because it's a fun tempo to do. I gave a little history about it. It seems to interest people. This is the first song I co-wrote, and I wrote it back in 1982 with Rory Burke, who's written millions of country hits. And I had a record deal at the time, and it was going nowhere. I mean, big time nowhere. And I couldn't sit on the song. I had to give it away. I had to, not only for him, I mean, that's what he does for a living, but I needed to pay the rent. And someone was interested, and they cut the song, and it became a single. It became a hit single, and it gave me fabulous writing credentials. I was no longer just somebody who wanted to be a writer. I was a writer, and it paid my rent, and I was very pleased and happy. But it also killed me that I had to give it away. It's sort of, they're all sort of like your babies. So we do it now on the show and on the album, and it's fun. Maybe you remember it. Gail Davies had an excellent record on it called Round the Clock Lovin'. Thank you. wasn't so hungry and poor when I wrote this one. I was awful lonesome. You're the picture of lonely if ever I saw one, sitting at that table. Darling, you look so alone. Don't know what happened, and I do not know your story, but if you had somebody, I think you'd probably be home. Hope you don't mind if I sit down beside you. I believe that we're two of a kind. Could be a little better if we got together. Cause hurting together meets a hurting alone, and two hearts are better. Thank you. Well, y'all are a depressed old bunch, aren't you? All right, I'm going to take a big chance now. I'm going to sing the very first song I ever wrote. Turn around. What's the matter? And I was a singer then, but I was doing this strange college concert tour with some Moog synthesizers. It was very, I don't know what we were doing, really. And I was living in New York, and we got to a place called Due West, South Carolina. Yep, little bitty old place. And we stopped in at the cafe. Well, now this is in 1972. And we stopped at the cafe to have breakfast. And I went to the ladies' room and I was reading graffiti. Thank you. And I read a lot of stuff that pretty low, but I read it anyway. And then very neatly printed, it was the penmanship that caught my eye. Very neatly printed was this sentence. It said, "I ain't never gonna love nobody but Cornell Crawford." dedicate this to all you 80s ladies out there and all the men you took with him. We were three little girls from school. One was pretty, one was smart, and one was a borderline fool. Well, she's still good looking. That woman hasn't slipped a bit. Smart one used her head, she made a fortune. Me, I cross the border every chance I get. thing's still on, cause honey, it ain't ringing. Show you what happened. You see these? See this shiny part? It's metal. It's got a little space in it, and I just poked my heel in it. And then I couldn't get my heel out of it. And I felt my life pass before me. And if this had happened when I was about 15, I'd have killed myself. But at 46, now y'all are gonna go home and said she was drunk. I saw her fall down, she was drunk. I'm not drunk, but honey, I'm about to get that way after this. You're very sweet. That was very embarrassing, but I thought I handled it very well, don't you? And they don't even nominate me for Entertainer of the Year. Husband comes in, he says, "Wife, turn down the television, turn off the radio and listen to me. I need to tell you about my day." And she sits down and listens, and he begins to speak. "When I left here this morning, I was bound and determined. I was never gonna come back, never. I was running from you, darling. I was running from my job. I was running from the kid in me. He never knows when to stop. I got as far as the edge of town. Then I turned my car around and I headed back to you. Husband says, "Wife, what do you think?" She says, "It's very interesting. Before we talk about your day, let's talk about mine." She says, "When I left here this morning, honey, I was bound and determined. I was never gonna come back. Never, never, I was running. I was running. I was running from my job. I was running from some wrinkles. No cream's ever gonna stop. I got as far as the edge of town. Then I turned my car around and I headed Thank you. Yeah. Let's have a little fun now. I'm going to introduce my band to you. As you can hear, they play absolutely beautifully. And they're very nice gentlemen, they're good guys, and they're also very cute. And I pick them for their playing expertise, but I mostly pick them for their cuteness. I spend an awful lot of time on that bus, honey. I ain't gonna be sitting there looking at no ugly boys. Yeah. So over here, I got me a blonde-haired, blue-eyed keyboard player named Joe Van Dyke. Real cute guitar player with nice long legs over there, Dino Zimmerman. Then I went out and got myself a black-haired, blue-eyed drummer named Owen Hale. Oh, these ladies stood up over here. Oh, those drummers, girls, I'm going to tell your mother on you. Never get on the bus, even if they tell you there's an emergency phone call for you. Don't get on the bus with those boys. Over here on some sterling backup vocals and bass guitar, real cute, soulful brown eyes, John R. Crowder. Sort of light brown hair and blue eyes, cute little thing, Mitch Watkins on guitar. That's my band, boys and girls. I call them Live Bait. And we call this song Younger Men. You know women peak at 40 and men at 19. Oh, I remember laughing my head off when I read that in a magazine. I was 20 at the time. see me coming up the hill, honey, now. Do you whisper my name just to bring a little comfort to me? Do you still like the feel of my body lying next to you? Well, I guess what I'm asking is, do you still love me, dear? Or do you lie awake thinking I'm the biggest mistake you ever made? Just by snapping them fingers, you can snap them fingers and make it all go away. Honey, would you? Do you miss me when I'm gone? Sometimes you wish I stayed gone just a little bit longer. Well, I guess what I'm asking is, do you still love me, dear? Anybody that saw me last year remembers that by now I started thanking people for what's been going on. I'm gonna do that again because it seems like a year later it's still happening. I finally got my life started here, folks, at the tender age of 45, 2 years ago. And I owe it all to people like you who bought my record, who called into the radio station and said, hey, play that again, I like it. Your radio stations for playing me in the first place. I owe all of this wonderful stuff to people like you. And while I'm looking you in the eye, I wanted to say thank you in person. Thank you, my babies. Now, the big question of the evening, my darlings, my dears, is, do you, after I've told you how much I love you, do you